In this video, we'll dive into why AsyncImage in SwiftUI doesn't catch any images by default, leading to potential performance issues and repeated network requests. Understanding this limitation is crucial for optimizing your SwiftUI apps, especially when dealing with images from remote sources. But don't worry, I'll show you the exact code and techniques needed to enable caching for AsyncImage, ensuring a smoother and more efficient user experience. Let's get started. And if you like these type of tutorials and you want to meet with me on a one-on-one Zoom call, go ahead and check out the link in the description for a mentoring session, rebeloper.com/mentoring. Now, today we are going to talk about caching asynchronous images. And real quickly, let me just show you what we are going to build out today. So I'm going to move away from this view. And please take a look at the console log right over here when I come back. So it's just loading and you see that it's just printing out. This is the fetched image. Now, if I navigate away, you see that this is already the cached image. And of course, if I just go back, it's just going to present the cached anyway. So this is what we want to build out today, because AsyncImage does not have caching at all, and we are going to use this. As you can see, we have cached AsyncImage, the library, and you can find it on my GitHub repository. So it's Rebeloper, github.com/rebeloper cached AsyncImage, and then you can just add it as a Swift package like I did right over here. And then you just basically, you are just going to import the cached async image. Yeah, I know, I'm just having this demo and it's not importing, but you can just go ahead and import it, import cached async image, and then you have access to it. Oh, I know, it's in the puppy view. There we go, cached async image. This is what we are going to build out, you will understand. Make sure that you take a look at the whole video so you better understand what this means. So, being that said, we're not going to use the library, we are going to build it out. So here is my starter project. So we have this content view, and you know, it's just the starter default Xcode project. Boost your iOS development skills and career with personalized mentorship at rebeloper.com/mentoring. With extensive industry experience, I offer tailored guidance and practical advice to help you build robust apps and stay ahead of the field. Whether you're a beginner or a pro, join me to enhance your expertise and succeed in the competitive iOS landscape. The link is down in the description. Now, let's start building out this, and we are going to cache the async image with that. So first of all, let's create a new file, and let's call this, let's just create a Swift file, it's easier. So cached async image. So this will be the view that we are going to create. Okay, we need to import SwiftUI. There we go. So first of all, we need a way to cache all of these images. And what we are going to do is load this into memory, cache it into memory. And we are going to create a dictionary. It will have a key of the URL that we are grabbing it from and the actual image. So let's create that first. It will be really simple. I'm making it file private, so you know it can be accessed only on this file. It's really specific, so this is appropriate. It will be a class, image cache. There we go. And with this will have a static private var of that, you know, that dictionary, that cache, URL and image. And of course, it will be an empty one when we are initializing it. Okay, and then we are going to grab an image from this cache. And I believe I missed an E right over here. Yes, there we go. Another static subscript URL and then URL. It's just going to return an image, which will be optional. Maybe we don't have an image. And let's set up our getters and setters. So get image, come on, cache. There we go. Image cache dot cache at that URL. So this is how we are getting it. I believe it's self-explanatory. And then how we are setting it. Image cache at that URL equals the new value. Pretty straightforward. I think this is really, really easy to understand. Now let's use this and create a view that we can use in SwiftUI. Instead of async image, we are going to create cached async image. So let's create a view right over here. I'm just going to use this view. And let's remove the preview so we see a little bit better right over here. And also the canvas. Let's remove that. Okay. So we have this my view. Let's rename this. So cached. And why? Well, hey, I'm just going to copy and paste. Okay. We have our body. For now, let's just have a text so we don't have any warnings. There we go. We have this nice view. So what do we need? Well, we do need to have some sort of a content, you know, the label of that image. So we are going to have this content of type view that we are going to use later on. And you could just use this one, or, you know, if you want this to be more Swift UI like, I prefer basically this one. That's why I just typed it out first. But you can use also the where keyword, where content is of type view. Now, this is what the Swift UI team uses for its views. Let's just use this one. So now we are going to set up some constants and we are going to create the initializer from that. So I'm just going to make all of these private, so it's not going to be accessible only through the initializer. So private let, of course, we need that URL. URL, and it's an optional URL. Another private let is the scale. So scale, and that is a CG float. Again, we need a private let transaction that is of type transaction. We are going to need all of these in the async image. You will see in just a second. I just pull this up a little bit, and then we need that content. So private let content, and this will look exactly the same as an async image looks like. So we are going to give back the content. And also, we are going to have an async image phase right over here on this completion. So async image phase on the first part of our completion. Okay, let's create our initializer and let's see how well Xcode does the auto completion. So that's fine. Well, for the scale, let's just have 1.0 by default, so you don't have to add that all the time. Transaction, let's just use a default transaction for that. So transaction, okay. And for the content, we need to change this to content. And I believe we are done. Yes, URL, scale, transaction, and content. Great. So now let's take care of our body. Well, this a cached async image should return an asynchronous image if we haven't fetched it, or if we haven't cached it for that matter. If we haven't cached it, it should fetch it and show it as an async image. Otherwise, it should fetch it from the cache. Okay, so we are going to check if the URL is valid, because, you know, it's optional if URL, and also if we have a cache. So cached, let's just call it cached, and that's just image cache for this URL. If that's true, then we are just going to say content, and we are going to use the async image phase of success. So dot success, and we are just going to move forward the cached image. So this, in this case, it should be already cached. We have that URL and we have a cached image at that URL. And let me just add a print statement. You don't have to do this. You can remove this later on, but I'm just going to add in here cache so we can see that it's actually fetching from the cached, so from the image cache. Okay. And yeah, here's a cool trick. You can't just add in print statements into your views. You just need to have let underscore and equals underscore, not the dash, underscore. There we go. Oh, come on. That's right. Okay, and let's have a tab over there. Okay, so otherwise, we want to fetch from that URL as an async image. So else. And we don't need to guard or if let unwrap that URL because async image needs an optional URL. So async image. And I'm just going to use the one with the URL scale transaction. Well, let's just use all of them. So URL, that's our URL. And then let's have the scale, that is our scale transaction. Let's just have that on the new line transaction. And then here comes the content. Now, as you can see, we have the async image phase, so phase. And then we are going to use that phase. But what are we going to use with that phase? Well, we are going to have a check, a cache and a render, because at this stage we are going to fetch it, but we don't really just want to, you know, use and move this state like we did right over here. We want to first cache it. So let's create a function for that. Func cache and render that phase, async image phase, and this will return some view. Okay, for now, let's just add a text so I can just add it right over here. So cache and render this face. Okay, so let's see. In this case, we want to make sure that we actually got an image. So if the face success, if case dot success, we have our image and we have that face, and also we have a URL, let URL, then we are just going to cache it. So image cache URL at the URL equals our image, and yeah, then we are going to also return that image. So that is after, yes, so let's return our image, return our content, and then the face. Okay, so if we do have an image and the URL is valid, then we are caching it. Otherwise, just move along and use this face. Okay, so great. Now it's time to create. Now, let's use this. Basically, this is it. If you take a look at my GitHub repository, it's this code. Now I want to give you an example. And for that, we are going to actually navigate away. So we are going to navigate to a puppy view. And also that puppy view will be presented as a part of the initial view on the content view. So let me just create a new file right over here. SwiftUI view, puppy view. Okay. And yeah, if you are using the actual GitHub repository, import cached async image right over here. Otherwise, we're just going to use the one that we have created. So let's see, cached cached async image. And I don't care about the scale in this transaction at the moment. Feel free to just use it if you want to. I'm just going to go with the URL and the content. Now for the URL, I'm using Pixum photos. Go ahead and check them out. I'm just going to copy it out right now and paste it over here. And for the content, as you can see, we are pretty exactly the same as with async image. We are going to get back an async image phase. So let's have a phase right over here. And we're just going to switch through that phase. So switch phase. And we are going to have an empty state. I'm just going to go with a progress view. This is when it's actually fetching. So, you know, it did not fetch an image or it did not get an error when fetching an image. It's just in progress. So for the empty state, I'm having a progress view. For the image, we are getting back this image. And it is actually an image view, as you can see. I'm just going to go with a small eye. Auto completion added that for me. Let's just have a resizable, and let's have a frame. So dot frame, and let's just have this. This means that it's of a width 200 and height 300. Let's just have that width of 200 and height of 300. Okay, that's our image. What do we do on the failure? Well, I'm just going to go with the color dot red now, right now, so we don't waste time building all of this out. But yeah, that's and also let's have that frame in there, why not? Okay, also we are going to let's just see what's the problem right over here. So let's take a look at this error. Let's go back to the async image. Oh yeah, we need to add at view builder right over there. And while we are here, let's just add another print statement of fetched right over there. Let's go back to the puppy view. This should go away. Yes. And then we need to add an unknown default. I'm just going with the fatal error right over here. Okay, so that is our puppy view. Now it's time to set up our navigation. So let's just go have a navigation stack right over there. So we can navigate on the content view. Okay, and inside the content view, I'm just going to replace this with a simple thing. Let's just have a puppy view and then a navigation link. So navigation link with the destination of puppy view. And then a label of text puppy view. Okay, let's just use the preview navigation stack. Let's see that. So let's open up the canvas right over there. And yeah, as you can see, it fetched it, and we do have also in the log fetched. Let's navigate to the puppy view. Now this is the cached one, and yeah, it's just like that. It's really, really straightforward. Now you could use this code or maybe improve upon it, or you could just use it from my GitHub repository as a Swift package, github.com/rebeloper/cached async image. And if you like these type of tutorials, go ahead and subscribe, or maybe you want to meet me on a one-on-one Zoom call. The link is down in the description, rebeloper.com/mentoring.